Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand I/O versus memory bus. So before this video, we have covered about introduction to I/O interfaces. If you haven't watched that video, please watch that video and come back here, because this diagram, we have discussed about this diagram in our previous video. So based upon this diagram, we will try to understand what is I/O versus memory bus. In our previous class, and every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist, our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. In the previous class, we have covered, we have understood about this, based upon this diagram, we have understood about interface, I/O interface. There we have said that all the I/O devices will get connected to the interfaces. These interfaces are used to convert. So it acts as a point between the devices and the processor's memory. So on the other side, we are going to have the memory along with its bus. So the memory RAM connected, the processor connected to the RAM and the associated registers of the processors. So which we have discussed in our basic computer organization. So whenever a device want to communicate with the whenever a device wants to communicate, which means some data needs to be sent by the device to the processor, and the processor wants to send some output values onto the to the device. So then that content has to be stored onto the memory, and that content will get stored on the processor's memory. Okay, so now so how this organization, so how this memory bus and I/O bus can be organized? So the concept that we have discussed is one of the way. There are different other types in which the memory bus and the I/O bus can be connected. So what are those different types? And that we will try to understand in I/O versus memory bus class. So in this class, we will try to understand the different types of I/O bus and the memory bus connections, how those connections will be done, that we will try to understand. So that there are three different types in which the I/O bus and the memory bus can be connected. It is use two separate buses, one for memory and other for I/O. So use two different buses, so one bus I/O bus and the other bus is a memory bus. So where the memory will get, the processor will get communicated with the memory by using the memory bus, and the processor will get communicated with the I/O devices by using the I/O bus. And each bus, so whether it is an I/O bus or it is a memory bus, it is going to have three different lines, or three different buses are combined into one single bus. It is called as I/O bus or memory bus. The three different lines are data bus, data line, address line and control line. So the data part for the devices and the data from the device to the processor will get transferred through the data line. Similarly, the address bus is going to transfer the addresses, and the control bus, so input, so load something onto the memory, load input something onto the I/O device. So those control lines, so those control lines will get activated, will get transferred by using this control line. Okay, so now the three different types, one of the type is use two separate buses, one is memory bus and the other one is I/O bus. So one for memory and the other for I/O. The other type is use one common bus. So to the processor, we are going to connect one common bus with three lines. One is data, other one is address, and the third one is control lines. So use one common bus for both memory and I/O, but have separate control lines for each. Separate control lines means if you take the memory bus, load something onto the memory, so that is a control. So that is what we call it as control statement. So all those kind of control statements will get transferred through control lines. So we have to have a common bus where the data line and the address bus is common for both the I/O devices and the memory device, but we should have separate control lines are to be maintained. So why those separate control lines and all those concepts, we will try to understand in our later video. This kind of organization is what we call it as isolated IO or IO mapped IO. Isolated IO or IO mapped IO. In our later videos, we will try to understand this concept. The other kind of organization of the IO bus and the memory bus is use one common bus. It is same, use one common bus for memory and IO with common control lines. In our previous in the second method, we are having separate control lines, but in the third method all the lines are common. Use only one common bus which consists of three lines. One is data line, address line, and the other one is common control line. So all these are common for all the devices, in the sense IO devices and the memory device. Okay, so this kind of organization is what we call it as a memory mapped IO. Memory mapped IO. In this class, we will try to understand about the first configuration. So first way of organization: use two separate buses, one for memory and other for IO. In this kind of organization, we have to use, whenever we want to use separate buses for memory and the IO devices, we have to use different processor for IO. So different processor for IO, which is what you call it as IO processor. So separate bus and separate bus for memory, where the CPU gets connected to the memory, and all these devices will get connected through the data, through this bus, to the IO processor. IO itself is having another processor, and this IO processor will get communicated with the memory. So this kind of architecture is very, very costly. This kind of organization is very costly. It is not used very much because of the cost factor. Okay, so what happens is, here we are going to have two different buses. This is a separate bus where the CPU will get communicated with the memory. The data transfer, address transfer, and the control transfers are done by the CPU through this bus to the memory. And similarly, the devices will get communicated with the IO processor, and the IO processor will talk with the memory. So this is one of the configuration. In our next coming videos, we will try to understand about isolated IO, IO mapped IO, and also memory mapped IO. So this is about how the bus configuration, bus organization can be done with the IO devices and memory device. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you like this video, please if you feel that this content is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol, and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.